We want to find the two smallest positive radian solutions to the trig equation 4 sine 2 theta equals 3. We might be thinking that we have to perform a substitution for sine 2 theta, but we're not going to. We're going to perform a substitution just for 2 theta. We're going to let beta equal 2 theta, which would give us the equation 4 sine beta equals 3. So we'll solve this equation for beta and then determine theta. Notice if we solve this equation for theta, we would have theta equals beta divided by 2. So we'll solve this for beta and then divide by 2 to determine theta. So to solve this equation, we'll first divide both sides by 4. So we have sine beta equals 3/4. Well, having a sine function value of 3/4 is not a value that we'll find on the unit circle or from reference triangles. So we'll have to use the calculator to help us solve this equation. But before we do that, notice how the sine function value is positive. And since sine theta is equal to y divided by r, this is telling us that the y coordinate must be positive in order for the sine function value to be positive, which means the angles that satisfy this equation must be in the first quadrant or second quadrant where y is positive. Next, since we have to use the calculator to help us find one of the solutions, if sine beta equals 3/4, then beta is going to be equal to arcsine or inverse sine of 3/4. So if we type this into the calculator, it will give us one solution for beta. So let's go ahead and do that. Because we want our answer in radians, let's make sure that we are in radian mode. So I'll press the mode key. Notice how radian is already highlighted, so we are in radian mode. So now we're going to press second sine for inverse sine, and then 3/4, close parenthesis, press enter. Now we are asked to round our solution to 3 decimal places, but this is beta, not theta. So to avoid any rounding errors, let's round this to 4 decimal places. So one solution for beta is approximately 0.8481. So we'll call this beta sub 1. Let's go ahead and sketch this angle in the first quadrant. Let's just say it's here. Well, since the sine function value is also positive in the second quadrant, if we sketch a reference angle in the second quadrant of 0.8481 radians, it'll have the same sine function value, which means the angle in the second quadrant with the terminal side here with a reference angle of 0.8481 radians would also be a solution to our equation. So here's beta sub 1. Then for beta sub 2, one way to find this angle would be to take pi radians, half a rotation, and then subtract this reference angle to determine the measure of the second solution. So let's go ahead and do that. We would have pi radians minus 0.8481. So the second solution for beta in the second quadrant is approximately 2.2935 radians. But remember, our goal is to find theta, not beta. And since theta is equal to beta divided by 2, we'll now divide these by 2 to find our solutions. So we have 0.8481 divided by 2. Now we will round to 3 decimal places, so theta is approximately 0.424. Now we'll find the second solution. So theta is approximately 1.147. Of course, these are both radians.
These are the two smallest positive radian solutions to the original trig equation in terms of theta. I hope you found this explanation helpful.